All right. So, Sharan, to answer your question about two animals in the frame and you're on IAF, what if the camera is focusing the the prey and you want the focus to be on the predator? So let's say this is a frame and there are two faces. So without actually worrying too much, there are two faces and you have set your camera to IAF, animal or human, doesn't matter, IAF. Let's say this is human for the time being. So if you have also enabled another parameter of the camera where it's supposed to mark the face, I'll tell you what that means exactly in the Sony camera in a bit. So in the camera settings, if you enable this parameter, it is going to put a small box around the subject that is called face detect, right? And after it detects the face, it's going to put a autofocus point on the priority face. Like, for example, this is the face which is being used and this is the autofocus point which is tracking the eyes. Now, I hope you know that in the Sony camera, you can actually tell the camera whether it should focus on the left eye or right eye. That is called right, left eye detect. Now, this can also be set to auto, which means whatever is the leading edge, if the face is turned towards you, whatever is the closest side will be picked up usually in auto. Now, apart from this, the third one, as I said, is the parameter where you can tell the camera to enable the face eye frame display. It's called the face eye frame display. Now, this green thing is the face eye frame display. Now, as you can notice, this has picked up the left object and it's focusing the IAF and taking this picture. Now, assuming this was on wide area selection. Now, if you are in the wide area selection, you cannot tell the camera to move the focus to this face. What you should probably do for that is go to zone. When you go to zone, you can either select this zone or this zone, and then automatically in that zone, wherever is the face, it will get enabled. Inside that face, eye will get enabled. That's one way to do it. Do not use wide to track subjects, because you know, if there are two subjects, it's very difficult to tell the camera which one to focus. Zone is great. Even so, if you move to flexible spot, sorry, I'm actually writing from the stylus. Now, even if your flexible spot is somewhere here, it's inside this frame, which is the face eye display. Anywhere inside it, it'll pick up the face and it'll pick up the eyes. So I would probably choose these two and not this. Hey guys, so somebody asked me on Instagram about the Sony's IAF capabilities, and we were discussing what happens when there are two animals in a frame, or let's say two people in a frame. When you enable IAF, which one would the animal with the camera pick up? Will it pick up the one on the left or on the right? So while I answered that using a notepad and a drawing, I would love to show that on a camera in practical. So I might not be able to go to Ranthambore, but we've got a couple of tigers from Ranthambore in Jayanagar. So let's say I'm on the Sony camera here. So I'm on the Sony, I'm just going to underexpose a little on my video. So I'm on the Sony camera here. Let's focus here rather than on the laptop. So I'm just going to underexpose here a little and try to hold it here. So guys, if you see my menu, right, my camera menu, sorry, I'll have to go there. I want you to set up a couple of things. One is I want you to understand there is this menu called the face eye set. In that, I want you to be on face slash IAF on. In that, subject detection is animal. So I have set a shortcut key in my camera where I can toggle between human and animal here. In this case, the moment I say animal, and then I basically have selected an autofocus point, which is, so let me just zoom in a little so that I fill the frame with the tigers. So I have selected an autofocus point, which is the wide here. In other words, it is focusing everything in the frame. It's able to pick up the focus from anywhere in the frame. Beg your pardon, it cannot focus everything in the frame. It just accounts for everything in the frame and it can focus something. So if you notice, there's already a small box on the tiger's eye. It is focusing the tiger's eye. If I focus, it becomes green. So that is because I've enabled eye AF, and this is the animal eye. So if I had people there, I could disable animal and I could get it to people. Now the problem here is, because I'm on a wide area, if you notice, I'm on a wide area, I'm not able to dictate which tiger I should focus. See, now it picked up the right tiger. So I cannot actually instruct the camera between the two which one it should pick up, because I have selected the entire area of focus. Now it went back to the right one. So perhaps in a situation like this, it's not a good idea to be in wide. I would probably choose something like zone. And if you notice, the zone is right on the right side here. So the moment the zone is on the right side and I press AF on button, where's the zone now? It's come back to the left. I'm going to go to the right side. You can see how the eye of the right side tiger is focused. The eye is now green. But if I want to focus the left side, sorry, my laptop went dark. So if I want to focus the left side, I just need to move the zone to this side and the tiger here will be picked up. So move it even more and then you can pick up anyone between the two eyes. Now there's also a setting in camera called how do we shift between left eye and right eye. You can actually make that auto or you can make that manual if you want the left eye to be focused always or the right eye to be focused. Keeping it in auto means it will select based on artificial intelligence, most probably the closest one to you from the camera. So that is probably a good way to focus between the two, using a zone between the left zone and the right zone, and the IAF is getting enabled. Now let us see what happens if you select an even smaller AF area. So in this case, let me select the flexible, expand flexible spot. I'll put that in the center. Now if you notice, there is no way the camera is going to be able to focus the eye, but I can do something interesting. Now, if I press this button, it's actually focusing in the middle, right? So I have actually configured one of the buttons in my camera. That is the button here. I'll take it here to actually do IAF. The moment I press that button, it picks up the eye, as you can see. And even if the autofocus point is away somewhere and I press the AF on button, while I press that button, it'll pick up the eye. Sorry, I'm not able to do both at the same time. You can see how this button is getting the eye to focus. And holding that, I can click pictures even though my autofocus point is somewhere else. But I cannot choose between the two. But unless I get my autofocus point here and focus, it's very easy for the tiger on the right side to be focused by the camera. So guys, be careful. Use the right autofocus area mode. In this case, don't use wide, use either a large or a expand flexible spot. I'll also show you another video, what happens when two people are there. This is for animals. Let me come back with a video just for you to understand how it is different when it comes to people. All right, so let's continue this lesson. Right now I am having two South Indian tigers on the screen. And let's see how this scenario is entirely different when it comes to people and human faces versus animals. So again, just to double check, I am on animal eye detection here. I'll change that to human, and I immediately, because in my camera I have enabled the face eye AF and I'm saying frame display. Let's see what it does. I'll explain it to you. Sets whether or not to display the detection frame when a person's face or eyes are detected. Available on face or eye priority and AF is on. All right. So which means the moment I go to the wide AF area, that is the wide, and I select this human detection, the camera automatically puts two boxes. You must be able to see that there are two boxes on either faces. Now, the thing is, it's telling you by marking it in a light colored box, which is a lighter gray, that it's going to focus the guy on the left. If I press the AF on button here, it's going to be focused on the left. Now, how do I get the focus to the right side guy? In fact, it's very simple. If you use touchscreen, you just have to touch this guy's face and focus. It'll focus that guy's thing. You press this guy's face and focus, it'll focus that guy's face. But let's say you don't want to use touchscreen. Sorry about that. I want to get rid of the touch screen. So now you don't want to use touch screen and you're seeing through the viewfinder. Then, you know, I would recommend going back to the zone. And in this case, if you have the left zone as I have here, he's going to focus the left zone of the camera. Now, if I move the zone to the right zone and press AF on, it'll fix the focus on the right face. So that's how you select the faces when you have IAF. Let's say we don't have either of the faces and the camera is in the center. Now, when you press the focus, you're not going to get the eye detect. As I said, I have enabled my left button, which is this one. And once I press that, you'll immediately get the eyes. If possible, if you can take this eye, this expanded AF area to any one of the boxes, even if you touch it by a millimeter and press AF on, you'll get the right guy. I'll just go very close to this face on the left. But I'll not go on the face. I'll just be on the periphery that will engage the left autofocus point, and you'll see how the left guy is enabled. So you don't have to really go to the eye from here. Select this or select this and the eyes are getting focused. Isn't that beautiful? That's why I love Sony.